So Wi-Fi 6 has become more common these days. We do have it in the newly released smartphones and computers, and I am sure that many of you would want to get your hands on the latest technology, even if you are on a BSNL connection. So today we are going to take a look at TP-Link's Archer AX10, which is one of the most affordable Wi-Fi 6 routers at 5500 rupees or $75, but it still delivers the features and performance that most people will need, and we are also going to discuss some of its shortcomings because it does lack some important features. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and let's get started. In the box, you get some papers, a power adapter, an Ethernet cable, and finally the router itself. I do like the looks of the AX10. It does look kind of smart with its design on top that reminds me of a bow tie, and even though I am not a fan of glossy plastic, the combination of different patterns and finishes does look appealing. The glossy plastic part is of course a fingerprint magnet, but you shouldn't need to touch your router frequently unless networking really turns you on. The router does have 4 antennas, but these are not removable, but their unusual shape does make this router look interesting. The green LEDs on the front of this router don't look premium at all, but they do their job and you can schedule them to turn off at night. At the back, you have a combined WPS and Wi-Fi toggle button above the reset button. Then you have 4 gigabit LAN ports and a gigabit WAN port next to it. And lastly, you have the power switch and a jack for the power adapter. Setting up of the router is pretty simple, and you can do it with a PC or directly with your phone using Wi-Fi. TP-Link's interface is feature-rich while still being easy to use, and you have all the usual features like guest networks, port forwarding, parental controls, quality of service, firewall, and access control. The router also supports OpenVPN, and you have some basic system logging features along with firmware update option. Most of these options are also available with TP-Link Tether app on phone, which is always nice to have. The Archer AX10 supports 2x2 MooMeMo and beamforming, but the biggest upgrade here is of course Wi-Fi 6, which is a huge upgrade from Wi-Fi 5. And you have some really great features like OFDMA and client scheduling. So if you have a lot of devices connected to your router, you are going to get a better experience. And in places where you have lots of other networks, Wi-Fi 6 is also going to help a lot. For online gaming, you are also going to get a smoother experience, and the speeds on Wi-Fi 6 standard are better too, and I was able to get around 841 Mbps in the best case scenario with the phone at 1 feet away from router. So that is significantly faster than a budget Wi-Fi router like Archer C6, and in the next room with one wall in between, I was able to get 573 Mbps, then going in a room further away, I was getting 264 Mbps. On 2.4 GHz network, I was able to get a maximum of 122 Mbps, but this speed didn't get affected much as I moved further away. You will of course also need devices that are Wi-Fi 6 compatible to get benefits of all the features, and even I have my ROG Phone 3 as the only device which has Wi-Fi 6, and it does display the 6th number on the Wi-Fi icon, which feels cool. But the newer laptops and motherboards are also coming with Wi-Fi 6, so you will be getting more and more Wi-Fi 6 devices soon. Wi-Fi 6 routers are also backwards compatible, so your older devices will just see it as a regular router. Also make sure that you are subscribed to the channel with bell icon, because I'll also be making a video on the Archer AX50, which is a higher end model of this router. Coming to the range of this router, it is pretty average, and it won't be more than a budget router like the Archer C6. It is still good enough for a single flat, but in my other flat, I get a weak 2.4 GHz signal, which is completely fine, and to get a better range even with Wi-Fi 5, you will have to spend 3 times the money, so the range of this router is as expected, even if it is not going to win any awards. One very important feature that many of the TP-Link routers, including the AX10, lack is a range extender mode. On the Archer AX10, the One Mesh support is not ready at the time of filming this video, but TP-Link has planned to add it with a firmware update. But if you are thinking that this router will be receiving One Mesh support soon, then you may find yourself to be wrong, because even though the One Mesh feature is planned for this router, TP-Link takes a really long time to actually add it. For example, with my Archer C6, it took them almost a year to add it, so you should get it eventually, but don't buy it expecting that you will get it in a few days. And I'll have a pinned comment where I will have an update on whether One Mesh feature has been added or not. But then again, it's not all bad news because the AX10 performs very well for the price, and that is what you are buying this router for. It is really going to be good enough for most people even on gigabit connections. So in conclusion, the TP-Link Archer AX10 is a very good budget Wi-Fi 6 router, but it does lack some important features even if not many people may care about those. It does lack a USB port, which you can find on other Wi-Fi 5 routers in its price range, and the lack of a repeater mode on these routers is something that I find to be a problem because the implementation of One Mesh is limited and exclusive to TP-Link products. But if you don't need the USB port, or you don't need to use it as a range extender, or if you have a dedicated range extender, then I can recommend this router. It does deliver on all the basics for Wi-Fi 6, and even though it lacks support for 160MHz channel bandwidth, I don't think that it should be a problem for most people, as you will see in my AX50 review. You can also go with the much cheaper Archer C6, which actually performs very well even if it is not Wi-Fi 6. But if you need to have Wi-Fi 6 without taking a big hit on your wallet, the Archer AX10 is a great choice. And that was it for this video. I'll have links to buy these routers in the video description. Let me know if you think that upgrading to Wi-Fi 6 is worth it in the comment section below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.